Assalamu alaikum guys, welcome back to Civil Engineers YouTube channel with the new lecture. Guys, it's important for civil engineers to guide normal people, non-civil engineering students and non-civil engineers, because they don't know anything related with civil engineering construction. If they want to construct their house, so it's important for them to know what is plinth beam, what is tie beam, what is foundation, what is floor, what is roof, etc. Because from many days I saw some comments in comments box of civil engineers YouTube channel, and I didn't know that non-civil engineering student and non-civil engineers are also watching me and they are watching my channel. So thanks for that. Today this video is for non-civil engineering students and also for non-civil engineers, because civil engineering students and civil engineers know about this topic which I'm telling you in this video. So let's start guys. Before some days, more people, they asked, sir, we want to construct a house, so please guide us, what is plinth beam, what is tie beam, what is floor beam, what is a DPC, what is foundation. So today I will clear your concept. So if you are civil engineering student, so you will also clear your concept about this. I know that civil engineers know about these things, but if you need, so watch the video. Let's start guys. If this video is helpful for you, so don't forget to like this video and subscribe the channel with press bell icon if you are new. Guys, more people, they want to construct their house without civil engineer. They start their works. There isn't any contractor, but they want to start their work. So you should know about something related with civil engineering construction works. So guys, first thing is what is plinth beam, then DPC, tie beam and floor beam, because this is a question of non-civil engineering students and non-civil engineers. They comments, more people are there, so this is specially for them. As you can see guys, this is guys, this is called footing, and this is NSL, natural surface level. Below the ground level, it's called substructure. And on the ground level, up the ground level, that is called superstructure. Guys, substructure is also called foundation. Okay, now I will tell you what is plinth beam, the first one. On the ground level guys, we provide plinth beam. This is called plinth beam. That's why, because in soil there occur settlement and cracks comes from the foundation. So therefore, to avoid the cracks, there we provide on the ground plinth beam. Okay, and the plinth beam is horizontal member and we design it from RCC. It is from RCC, reinforced cement concrete. So we provide steel in this plinth beam. And guys, the depth of plinth beam should not be less than 9 inches. It should be 9 inch. Okay, plinth beam, this is called plinth beam. Guys, on the plinth beam, there we do to the plinth level, if the depth is more, so there guys we provide brick masonry. So this is brick masonry. When we got or when we get the plinth level after brick masonry, so there we provide a small layer which thickness is from 2 to 3 inches or 2 inches. Normal thickness of the DPC is 2 inches. So guys, this layer is called DPC. This is called DPC, and DPC stand for dam proof course. Okay, so we provide DPC, dam proof course, and the thickness should be, DPC thickness should be 2 inches. Normal is 2 inches, but you can take to 3 inches also. So this is called DPC, and we provide it also for seepage. Okay, this is DPC, and it also gave us a plain surface. After that, guys, we provide again brick masonry. We provide brick masonry. Okay, so this is brick masonry. After DPC, we provide brick masonry for house. Guys, there we provide one other. So plinth beam is also done and DPC also. Now we have tie beam. So to the height of lintel, our lintel beam and also tie beam is same, guys. Okay, and tie beam we provide to the height of lintel. So this is called tie beam to make the structure strong. Okay, and also guys, tie beam is provided to the height of 7 feet. Okay, this is also called lintel beam, and guys, it's why to the height of 7 feet? Because of 7 feet, it's called lintel. So above the door and windows we provide tie beam to make it strong. Okay, this is called tie beam, and tie beam is also provide for avoid cracks in the wall and also in door and windows. Okay, at edges, and also the depth of tie beam should not be less than 6 inches. It must be 6 inches. This is other point. On the tie beam we also provide brick masonry again to get the height for roof. So guys, on the top near or touch with slab we provide the other beam. This is called floor beam or top beam. This is called floor beam or top beam or special beam. Okay, this is also from RCC, reinforced cement concrete. This is also from RCC. Okay, Then we provide on the top of floor beam or top beam or special beam, we provide the slab. So guys, these are very helpful for you. This is called footing. For columns we provide, okay. The next is on the ground level we provide plinth beam, okay. This is called plinth beam. On the plinth beam we do masonry to the height of level, plinth level. Then we provide DPC, damp proof course, to the thickness of 2 inches normal, okay. Then brick masonry to the height of lintel. On the lintel height we provide tie beam. On the tie beam we provide brick masonry, okay, for ventilation, okay. So on that we provide floor beam or top beam or special beam. Now on the top beam or on special beam or on floor beam, on the last one we provide what? Slab. So when the gravity loads comes on the slab and slab transfer the load to floor beam, to this one, and floor transfer the load to the columns, okay, to the columns, and also the brick masonry and column transfer the load to the plinth beam, okay, and plinth beam transfer the load to the footings or foundation. So this is the process of load transfer mechanism of house, we can say. And guys, the other one is DPC. So DPC is just damp proof course. We don't design it for the load, to support the load. So it gave us the plain surface to do the brick masonry on that, and also for seepage, etc. And guys, also tie beam is designed to avoid the settlement. Also plinth beam is designed for avoid the settlement and also for cracks, because cracks comes from the foundation to the wall. If we direct provide on the foundation wall, so the wall become crack. So therefore between wall and foundation we provide plinth beam, because plinth beam avoid the cracks which comes from foundation to the wall, and wall will also make more cracks, so it will be danger for the house. So guys, this is the important topic for non-civil engineering students and also for non-engineers, but also helpful for civil engineers if they didn't know about this. So I hope it will help you in the future. So if you have any question related with this topic, so you can comments, I will try to reply your answer. Thanks for watching. See you in next video. Goodbye.